The whole world would have been upon disbelief. It will decrease Allahu Tabaraka wa Ta'ala in His might. It will decrease Allahu Tabaraka wa Ta'ala in his lordship. It's not going to decrease nothing in Allahu Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. No, if the whole humanity were to be upright, what will it increase to Allah? Nothing. So if we worship in Allahu Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, it's a favor for us. It is a favor for us. Allahu Akbar, Allah guide you and reward you with the Jannah. Allah guide you and aid you to be upon what is correct. Akhi, the fact that you are guided upon Islam is a favor from Allah. The fact that you are upon the guidance of Allah, it is another favor of Allah. The fact that you will make it in the Jannah, may Allah make me and you all from the inhabitants of the Jannah, this is another favor from Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. What have we done? Alhamdulillah, if we were to take all our life to thank Allah for guiding us to Islam, we will not be enough thankful in regard to the favors of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. Naam. And also He make the Muslims to be barakallahu fikum, meaning the elite of the people, the heads of the people. And also the guidance of the people. Allah had made the Muslim like this, walhamdulillah. And He made وَجَعَلَ حَيَاتُهُمْ بِهِ حَيَاتُ الطَّيِّبَةِ الْمُبَارَكَ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْبَرْزَخْ وَالْآخِرَةِ. And He, Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, made by way of al-Islam the life of the jinn and the human beings to be a pure life, to be a life that is, walhamdulillah, a healthy life. And some of us can relate to this more than others. Some of us can relate to this more than others. Imagine a person not knowing nothing but drugs, not knowing nothing but alcohol, and this and the third from the most evil things in life. And Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala guided him to Islam. He will not be as appreciative as a person that never knew these things. Even though he can be very grateful to Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. But this individual really know that Allah Ta'ala saved him from true darknesses and brought him to the light. And He made their life by way of Islam to be a life that is healthy, a pure life. A life, walhamdulillah, you will not be doing things that will harm you. Because Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, whatever He made haram, it is because of two reasons that we studied one time. Number one, it is 100% harm itself. Or the harm outweighs the benefit. Everything that Allah Ta'ala tells us not to do, it is ghaliban because of these two things. Whether it is 100% harm that is in it, or it is that the harm it contains outweigh the good that is in it. So alhamdulillah, a person living a life where he will abandon the imperatives, whether it is the imperatives that is hissi or ma'nawi, then alhamdulillah, the individual will live a life that is a life that is tayyib, and also that is mubarakah, that is a life that is full of blessings. Akhi, mubarakah, you do a little and you will gain much. You do a little, you will gain much. You pray one salah, you will be rewarded 10 salah. You pray 5 salah, it is the equivalence of 50 salah. You fast the month of Ramadan plus 6 days in Shawwal. كَأَنَّكَ صَامَ الدَّهْر كُلْ. As you have fasted the whole year. You make wudu. And Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala expiate your sins as long as the water still remain on you. You shake your brother's hands as long as you are holding on to the handshake. That Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala making your sins drop. You come into the masjid. Every step you take, it is a reward. Every other step you take, it is a remover of your sins. Isn't it barakah? You do a little and you will be rewarded. You build a house, a masjid in this world. Allah will build a what? A house in the Jannah. You aid in establishing a masjid. Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala will build a house for you in the Jannah. Ayyuhuma a'zam. Which one of these two is greater? You building a little, you know, helping $2 here, $3 there, you know, to pay the rent or to build, establish the masjid. And Allah Ta'ala establishing for you, building for you a what? A house in the Jannah. You raise your children properly upon Tawheed. Give them a good upbringing. And you die. They make dua for you. And those dua will be what? Will be good deeds for you. This is barakah, barakallahu fiqh. You do a little. And alhamdulillah, you will be rewarded greatly. You will be rewarded greatly. We pray at 9 o'clock. Somebody want to call it? Yes, go ahead. I want to go. Yes, Yusuf. What did he say? Huh? Oh, he wanted to call it. All right, this man already. Go ahead. Tomorrow, inshallah, see me. Who's that? Al-Ghaib? Some. Oh, Fadl, yeah.
This.
You can take this page and this page. So he mentioned, Hafidhahullah, Rahimahullah, that Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala make their life, that is to be a pure life, a healthy life. In this dunya, and likewise wa fil barzakh. And the barzakh is the waiting period or the waiting place between the akhirah, the dunya and the akhirah. How is it that Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala will make the life of the Muslims to be a pure life in the barzakh? That's one of them. But before that, before that, that's correct though, that's correct. Before that, if I say before, I want to just hear the first stages. أحسنت يثبت الله الذين آمنوا بالقول الثابت في الحياة الدنيا والآخرة that giving, barakallahu fikum, giving the thabat, right? Giving the thabat that you are upon la ilaha illallah in this life, but upon death, when munkar and nakir will ask you, Allah will strengthen your tongue to be given the proper answers. Now this is from, alhamdulillah, what Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala has given, baraka and a good life in the life of the barzakh. And we all know, alhamdulillah, wa fil akhirah, and likewise giving them a good life in the akhirah. And the best of that which will be given in the life of the akhirah, seeing Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Seeing Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala is the best that Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, that a certain Muslim believer will have yawm al-qiyamati. May Allah make me and you to be seeing Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Ameen. Shaykh Zayd rahimahullah, he say, wa rahim Allahu al-Faruq, and may Allah have mercy on al-Faruq. Ameen. Allahu Akbar. May Allah have mercy on al-Faruq. Al-Faruq huwa man? Man huwa al-Faruq? Who is al-Faruq? Who is al-Faruq? Al-Faruq, man huwa? Who is al-Faruq? Shu'aib, who is al-Faruq? Sit down. I'm about to ask you. Barakallah feek. Don't be never ashamed to say, I don't know, if you don't know. It's not going to take you, right? It's not going to take away anything from you. If you don't know, listen, say, I don't know. If you don't know, say, I don't know. Don't never say, well, my name is Shu'aib. I'm the man making the coffee, son. Nah, say I don't know if you don't know. May Allah aid you and plead and help you. Yusuf, who is Al-Faruq?
I think he's
Ahmed, I'm gonna ask you too, okay? Al-Faruq.
I think he's a companion.
Ahsanta, very good. He is a companion. But you left us hanging too. A companion. That's a good answer. Very good answer. You're right. You're very right. He's a companion. Ahmed Al-Faruq. Say it a little loud. Don't be shy to say, I don't know. Say it loud. I don't know. Barakallah. Fawzi? Abdul Razak? Who's Al-Faruq? He say, huh? What you know about that? Abdul Rahman? Al-Faruq, man huwa? Nobody raising their hands? Oh, man. Al-Faruq? Babakar? Al-Faruq? Umar ibn al-Khattab, radiyallahu anhu wa arda, Al-Faruq. Umar ibn al-Khattab, radiyallahu anhu, Al-Faruq. He say, wa rahim Allah, Al-Faruq, Al-Khalifatu al-Rashid. عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنه الذي حفظ عنه أنه قال he said may Allah have mercy upon Al-Faruq. عمر ابن الخطاب, who was one of the right godly khalifa after Abu Bakr رضي الله عنه وأرضى, الذي حفظ عنه, it was memorized from him, or it was recorded from him, annahu qala, that he said these beautiful words, intabihu, he say, nahnu qawmun, we are a people, a'azzanallahu bil islam, we are a people that Allah has honored and elevated with al islam, falan nabtaghi al-izza bighayrihi.